Hello and welcome to this Android Studio tutorial. My name's Cal and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a tabbar application using Fragments. We're going to be building this using Kotlin, and if you've seen any of my previous tutorials you'll no doubt notice that they're all in Java. Google's really embraced Kotlin and I think it's about time that I did. If you enjoy this Kotlin tutorial, please let me know. If you'd prefer that I stick with Java, let me know that as well. But yeah, let's get started.
Creating a new Android Studio project, empty activity, I'm going to call this Fragments Tabbar Tutorial. Kotlin is our programming language, and just hit finish. First thing we're going to do is head into the build gradle, and we're just going to add a plugin. So we're just going to apply the Android extensions, the Kotlin Android extensions, and then hit sync. Then we're going to head into colors. We're just going to add a few different colors. So I'm creating a gray tab background color, as well as just a basic blue, which we're going to make our main theme color. So we're going to make it as our tab icon tint, as well as it's going to change the tab bar color. So we're going to close off all that now, and we're just going to right click and we're going to create some fragments. So I'm just going to create a blank fragment, calling it home fragment. Then I right click again. I'm going to say new fragment. I'm going to call this one list. So list fragment. And then we're going to create a third one and another blank fragment. And we're going to call this one chart fragment. And basically when you create a fragment, it gives you all of this garbage code that you don't need. So I'm just going to delete all of that on our first fragment, and then I'm going to copy and paste onto our other two, clicking, selecting and pasting, and then just need to change the class name as well as the layout to be the matching correct one. So list for list, and same thing on the home fragment. We're just going to change the name as well as the layout. Cool. And now we can close off those Kotlin files. I'm going to head into each one of the XMLs and we're just going to make it each one distinguishable. So we're just going to make the text view size a little bit bigger. I'm going to set the alignment to the center, gravity, center, text color to be white for this one, because we're going to make the background color. Let's make it purple. So make the background purple. I'm going to change the text to say chart fragment. This is going to be one of the views. And then we're just going to copy and paste that text view into our list fragment, just renaming that to list fragment. We'll make the background color of this one teal. And our home, we're going to change the color of the text color to black and just leave the background color as white, and just changing the text to home fragment. So we can close off all three of those now, and we're just going to head into our main activity. We're going to change our constraint layout to a relative layout. We're going to remove the text view and we're going to add in a view pager. And so be careful to select view pager 2, because there is a view pager 1. Layout width, height, match parent, and just giving an ID of view pager. Below that, we're going to create a tab layout, width of match parent, height, wrap content, tab max width is 0 dp, tab gravity is fill, tab mode fixed, and we're going to give it a background color of our tab background color. And then here we're going to say app tab indicator color, and we're just going to give it our color primary, which is what we said earlier as blue. And then we're going to just say align parent to the bottom is equal to true, so that the tab layout sits at the bottom, giving our tab layout an ID of tab layout. Now view pager, we just want to say layout above our tab layout, and then you can just check by clicking on both of those views. Cool. So now we can open up our tab layout, and inside that we're going to create a tab item. We're just going to say width and height wrap content, and just calling this first one home. We're going to copy and paste that on that two more times, changing them to list and chart. So now we can head back into our main activity. We're going to create a new Kotlin class. We're going to call it Tab Page Adapter. Our Tab Page Adapter class is going to receive two inputs. The first one being activity, which is of type fragment activity, and the second one being tab count, which is of type int. And our Tab Page Adapter extends fragment state adapter. And then we can click on this error message and implement both of the override functions. So the first one is get item count, and we're just going to return our tab count that we pass in. One of the cool things about Kotlin is that you can actually do this in one line. You just need to remove the curly brackets, equals, and then you can just return our tab count that way. So that's doing exactly the same thing. And then in our create fragment, we're just going to return when our position, which is passed in through our create fragment, when our position is 0, we want to return our home fragment. Otherwise, we want the default to be our home fragment. If it's 1, we want to show our list fragment. And if it's 2, we want to show our chart fragment. So that's just based on the position of our tab layout. And one thing I forgot to do is we just need to pass our fragment state adapter, the activity that is passed in through the tab page adapter. And then we're just going to head back to the main activity. We're going to create a function calling it setup tab bar. Inside here, we're going to declare our tab page adapter, calling it adapter. We're going to pass it in the activity is this, so our main activity, and our tab layout tab count. Tab layout is just coming straight from the activity main XML. In Kotlin, you can do away with find view by ID by just referencing the ID directly. So we named our tab layout, and our view pager, we just gave it an ID of view pager. And that's what we need to do here, just assign our adapter to our view page adapter. Below that, we're going to say view pager register on page callback, giving it view pager 2 on page callback. And then we're just going to override the function on page selected. And we just need to set selected tab of our tab layout. And we're going to get the selected tab by just calling our tab layout again, get tab at position. And so basically what this on page callback listener is doing is it's listening for when the user swipes the view pager. We need to set our tab layout selected tab to be the correct tab. And what we're going to do next is basically the opposite. So we're going to add a listener to our tab layout to set the view pager to the correct page when the tab layout changes. To do that, we're just going to say tab layout add on tab selected listener. We're going to override three functions. So the on tab selected, on tab unselected, and on tab reselected. We only need to update in the on tab selected. We're going to say view pager current item is equal to tab position. Just remove the question mark from the on tab selected so that it's non-optional. Nice. And if we go and run this, we can see that we can scroll through the tabs and it changes the view, and we can actually scroll through on the swipe. Next, I'll show you if you want to add some images, it's quite easy to do. We're just going to create a couple of drawable assets. So I'm just going to right click new vector asset, and then I'm just searching for really any icon, doesn't really matter too much, and just hitting OK. And then we head into the activity main and just need to say Android icon is equal to our baseline home. And then we're going to do the same thing for the next two. So all three have an icon. And if we go and run this again, you can see that the icons have all come through. But yeah, that's how to build a tab bar application in Android Studio using Kotlin. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.